My friends, let's briefly talk about the money creation process of the central bank today. Let's look in some detail, but simply basically, at the two highways that the central bank uses as a way of creating money these days. Does the central bank print money? Are there such big economic problems? Why does the central bank print money? There are questions such as not meeting their needs. Let's find answers to these questions. What we call the central bank's printing of money, I'm not talking about cash. Because the money we use in today's world is more a lot of fiat money, namely fiat money. Let's explain like this. I'm saying roughly right now in Turkey numbers. Cash, that is, the volume of emissions, the amount we call is TL 220 billion. We call this the emission volume. Emission volume, which also means banknotes in circulation, refers to the total amount of banknotes issued by the central bank.
Yes, the emission volume, that is, the cash flowing in the market is TL 220 billion. But what about the banks? For the total amount of money in bank deposits in TL, I'm talking 1.4 trillion. So 7 times. So we actually, center the bank is in our pocket by printing money, not the cash we have, but the money in our bank. Asking the question whether it increases the deposit necessary.
That's what the central bank does. In order to understand the economic trend, the important thing is that the central bank's deposits any increase in performed or not. This central bank, open market operations trying to do it through. For TL side I'm talking. Let's explain like this. Actually the central bank is currently printing money in Turkey. So how does it print? Of the central bank any debt directly to the treasury it has no authority to give. Such a has no right. Is prohibited by this law. So essentially, our money creation, what we are saying is this. Actually somehow what is required is, treasury in the hands of the state distribute the money to the people. Hence, the government must have money. At the moment the state does not have such money. The central bank of this money somehow must be created from. Already is being created. How is it created? Let's explain the mechanism. Center bank's customers are banks. The central bank lends to banks from time to time. He does this to increase the amount of money in the market. While doing this, banks have to lend when borrowing from the central bank. There are guarantees. These collaterals are bonds and bills. In terms of making money, banks can create money by selling their treasury bonds and bills to the central bank. On the other hand, they can give government bonds and treasury bills as collateral and receive money from the central bank. The central bank can use another way if it wants to. The central bank tells the banks, hey banks, if you have bonds, bring it. Otherwise, the government is currently issuing bonds and bills. Get it on the bond.
So create a resource to the state. Then this bond to me, bring it. I give you in return for this, I'll give you money. So actually you pull the bank out of the way, the central bank he somehow gave money to the state to the treasury is happening. The government distributes this money to us. There are donations and so on. This was the first highway. What we use in the money making process.
2. Let's come to the highway now. The second, again similar mechanism through this unemployment being implemented. And that's in that unemployment fund deducted from our salaries, here's deductions, resulting money not held in cash. With these deduction coins, the state bonds and treasury bills. In other words, the unemployment fund has government bonds, not money. Since government bonds cannot be distributed to citizens, these assets need to be converted into cash. Here is the central bank, he told the banks, go to the unemployment fund which take the assets and give cash. In this way cash in hand of unemployment fund has occurred. In the bank's bonds from the unemployment fund.
They went and gave it to the central bank. So what happened? Central bank somehow he gave money to the unemployment fund. A money that didn't exist before? Banks created through unemployment. To whom did that money go from the fund? Our went into the pockets of the citizens. So again, creating a new money mechanism has been realized. So why can't this process be done continuously? Why sometimes refuse being done?
Being done? Because if you notice, there is a part of the treasure in every money creation process. There is a government borrowing due to bond issuance. Once public, we're seeing debt increase. Besides, there are already 100 units in an economic system. When there is production, if there is 100 unit money, and if you face the amount of money in the system, if you increase it from units to 200 units, the price of a good that is 1 lira in the system is equal to 2 liras. May come out. Therefore, the amount of money also has an effect on inflation. Conceivable. However, in the current environment, The inflation issue is ignored as the demand is very low. In addition, for our country's economy.
Another critical issue, when foreign investor invests in our country, inflation level and TL at least to a certain level he invests because he has expectations about it. But if you print more money, increase the amount of TL, which when the amount of something increases, its value decreases. In other words, there will be a decrease in the amount of foreign investors' investment in TL and Turkey. So what's going on? Foreign investor, it is getting harder to invest in Turkey. Out of existing investments, causing it to come out. Therefore, this situation creates a pressure on TL and causing it to rise. That's why we constantly do this.
We can. Apart from this, in the fiat money system, we call the money base, which the central bank can intervene in. What does the money base mean in this context? Cash plus banks, central bank, means deposits. In order for the center, namely the monetary base, to have an effect on deposits, other factors beyond the control of the central bank also come into play. We call these factors money multipliers. We'll work the money multiplier again. For now, in this context, let's think about as much as we need. The money multiplier logically indicates the possibility of money being converted into loans through banks.
Again, it is a functional definition. The money multiplier logically denotes the possibility of converting money into loans through banks. This includes, either banks have to have a higher appetite for lending, or the citizens' desire to keep their money in the bank as deposits rather than in cash should be greater. It would actually serve this purpose, there was such an administrative measure. Active ratio. What is active ratio?
Asset ratio was calculated by the public authority from bank data, especially deposits and loans, and aimed to punish those who encourage lending and those who are reluctant to lend despite collecting deposits. This is a purely administrative practice and some periods are applied, some periods are not. Guys, I want to ask you a discussion question now. In the past, the central bank used to lend directly to the government. It no longer gives. So how do governments borrow money? The central bank lends to banks.
Banks sell the money they receive from the central bank to the government in exchange for bonds. Of course, the central bank lends to banks at cheaper interest rates. And banks sell the money they get cheap from the central bank to the treasury, government, with higher interest. In fact, this issue has dimensions that should be considered in the context of the European Union.
While the central countries of the European Union and especially Germany are the countries where the banks that earn high interest are settled, the governments of countries such as Mediterranean countries, especially Spain, Italy, pay high interest rates. It is clearly seen that the central European powers are exploiting the periphery, Mediterranean Europe, by way of interest. In the past, at the end of the global crisis, for example, Germany tried hard not to change this exploitative practice and not to make any exceptions. He insisted that the money poured into the economies be given to the banks, and that if the governments were going to borrow, they should borrow from the banks.
Because the banks receive the money they receive with an interest of about 1%, for example, he gave it to the Spanish government at 6.90% interest. It is not possible for Spain to roll over its debts and reduce its debts with the money it found with 6.90% interest. Spain is just one example. As you can imagine, there are countries with worse conditions.
Banks are openly exploiting national treasury and making large amounts of easy money through nation states. My question is, do you think this is an irreversible stage of the globalization of financial capital? Or can nation state governments get out of this mousetrap? How can it be saved?